Hey, Rainy Joe here, and welcome to the last video of Metal March. Throughout the month of March, we've been listening to metal albums, and here's the last one we are doing. It is no longer March, but we are rounding out the series because, again, like I said, I want to do 10 albums per genre every month. So, even though we are creeping into April now, we are finishing things off with Opeth's 2001 album, Blackwater Park. This has been a highly requested album. In my comments for metal music, as far as I've seen, I think three or four people have already mentioned this one specifically. And I don't know much about it. It's 1 hour and 7 minutes long. I know Opeth is a pretty well-known, famous Swedish metal band. And I've seen them be compared to the King Crimson of metal, which I assume it's because of their prog metal roots. Kind of reminds them of people of the King Crimson prog rock roots. But again, that's a very bold take because King Crimson is considered one of the greatest bands of all time. So if Opeth fills that void in the metal scene, I'm excited to hear it. So without further ado, let's not waste too much time considering the length of this thing, a pretty mammoth sized album it would seem compared to some of the other releases we've done, and I don't want this video being too long. So 1 hour and 7, 8 tracks, Leper Affinity, the first track here. Creeping piano to kick it off. Made me jump. I should have turned this down a little bit. What a kick into that intro. I did not expect death metal vocals, but maybe I should have looked into that. Not that I'm afraid of that. Very clear, well-mixed production. Oh God, the grooves on this thing. God. Very punchy drums falling right into these gliding guitars that kind of just elevate and descend. Feel like we're on a wave. The guitar work is so clean and just so well mixed above everything. Oh, I really love that breakdown there as it shifts over. Impeccable use of space there. Oh, these gentle passages, kind of just offering some sort of solace between these crushing instrumentals. And vocals. Oh, I did not expect this shift in his vocals, such a clarity in them. Oh, that's very King Crimson-esque, very much so. Remind me of Epitaph, I believe it is. That effect he's using there. I'm loving the very prog focus of this track. Oh, and right back into that guttural vocal. Does this have anything to do with leprosy, given the track's title? 7.5 minutes, and it has not felt like it. The pacing is fantastic. Perhaps the protagonist of this track is suffering from leprosy. Your body is mine to avail. Such a tragic sight you are. I think that's what I'm gathering. That the protagonist is suffering from a sickness. Now we're just transitioning right into a slow piano outro, perhaps. What a gentle ending. I believe the pro oh, sorry, I thought this was over. What I'm trying to say is, I thought the protagonist seems to be suffering from sort of sickness. Going right into bleak here. Maybe it continues that story, maybe it doesn't. Let's find out. I like the strings here. The instrumentals are so proggy. I love it. Nice diversity in it. Ah, can't tell what these lyrics are alluding to. Certainly some sort of darkness to it, though. I just love the constant shifting. The way it kind of like did that rise into the drums. Kind of like a Middle Eastern sound as well in the background there. The atmosphere that's developed there. Really gorgeous production on this album so far. Like, it's just such a very polished listen. It's gotta be about a sickness or a death. Perhaps mourning. Can't tell which vocal I like more, the rougher guttural one or this cleaner one. This cleaner one kind of reminds me of a lot of early 2000s bands. Perhaps that's their influence. I love just how easily this band can shift into these very like otherworldly instrumentals to these softer tones. And then the uses of space too. I love a good use of silence and very claustrophobic listens such as this. Nice bass as well. Whatever the bass player is. Martin Mendez. This is a heavy riff. I love that. That riff is really just like gnarly. Again, I cannot tell exactly what this is about, but lots of themes of words that seem to reference death. Final words, white clouds on your eyes. Cold fingers mark this dying wreck. Well. Kick into almost like a thrash metal tone here. God, it's so warbled. Closing things out. Another fantastic track, very dynamic. I think I like the opening track a smidge more, but I thought this one was still fantastic. Going right into Harvest here. The shortest one, I believe. Oh no, the source will be 1:50, but this is 6 minutes pretty much, and the second shortest. I think this is the from the perspective of the dying here. Maybe it's somebody suffering from another illness such as cancer, but it's definitely a sickness theme throughout. Love the acoustics on this one as well. This track much more stripped back. A nice breather. Maybe the dying here is seeing his afterlife. That's what the orchard is. Alright, going into the Drapery Falls, I just wanted to say Harvest. Nice little, you know, gentle, relaxing breather. Not as claustrophobic as these openers were in some instances. Not that they had, you know, no moments of solacelessness, which they certainly did. But it was a nice stripped back track. And let's go into the 11-minute track here, Drapery Falls, and see if it gets back into things with the more crushing sound of metal. But it definitely seems like this album is focused on someone who is dying. From what? You know, some sort of illness, it would seem. Could be leprosy. But that almost seems like it might be too easy given the title or the opening track. Very ethereal tones as well, very atmospheric, kind of moody. I love that effect he uses on his voice. Sounds almost like otherworldly. It's certainly taking its time a little bit more and developing itself. I do like the way it keeps shifting from the interesting vocal effect onto this one here, where he's kind of just belting it out over this explosion of sound. Oh, I completely forgot about this vocal, and it just comes right in, heavy. Not sure what this track is about either. Again, certain levels of crypticness to each track here. Really punchy, that instrumental. Ugh. It's so repetitive too, the way it kind of beats on you. It is unforgiving, for sure, in its delivery at times. Every time you get that nice moment of peace, you are then shaken up shortly after. Seems like it's got a long outro, the way it's slowly fading. I'm not sure how I feel about this track though overall, as we're closing it out. But maybe it'll grow on me, maybe it'll take some more listens. And going right to next year, we got Dirge for November, another fairly lengthy track, 7 minutes 51 seconds. Maybe it's not all connected, can't quite tell, but let's take this one independently. It seemed whoever the point of view of this track is, maybe they are alone. They've been abandoned. I like that gentle guitar in the background. And there it is. I'm not sure how I feel about this one again. Instrumentally, it's overwhelming. Maybe it's because I'm not used to it. Maybe because it's throwing a lot at me here. But it's overwhelming to the point of sickness inducing. It's hard for me not to make the connection that this is still about some sort of sickness. I gotta believe it. Preparations are done. The mere reflection brought disgust. These gentler passages, the more atmospheric elements, to me, are some of the more standout moments. As they really do build the atmosphere quite a bit. I like the very kind of reverb focus of it too. A really beautiful passage to close things out. Dirge for November, a decent track. I think, again, a lot of this album will take more listens to fully grow on me, for me to understand. Those overwhelmingly crushing instrumentals can sometimes be a bit much. Despite that, it's still very well produced. I will say the production of this thing is very clean, very sharp, just polished in every way, but doesn't feel overproduced. It feels very much meticulous. Here's the Funeral Portrait, another lengthy track at 8.5 minutes, just over. I do like this riff here so far, much more easily, you know, noticeable riff. These vocals are not really working for me at this point. It's just too overblown for me to even digest it. I do like this main riff that's been, you know, been used throughout this track so far. Don't get me wrong, they have great lyrics as well. I think this one, again, lots of themes of death throughout. I believe most of this album is about mourning the loss of someone and dying, perhaps from a sickness, and crossing to the afterlife. And another long fade out, which is another thing about this album that isn't particularly to my interest. I don't like the way these tracks, you know, tend to just either transition right into another or just have a long fade out. Almost like there's no resolution. And maybe that's an intentional thing within the theme. I don't know. I apologize if this is a huge album for you, one that you love. Maybe it's one of your favorites, but it's not among my favorites I've heard this month. Here you have Patterns in the Ivy, 1:50, the shortest track, an instrumental. I do love the gentle guitar work on this album, the more acoustic sounding elements. You guys are gonna hate me, but this is one of my favorite tracks so far. I just love that gentle, oh, and the piano coming in here. You know what though, three songs that I was not particularly fond of like the others isn't too bad, considering I did like those first three tracks quite a bit. And let's just go right into the final track here, the title track, Blackwater Park, 12 minutes. I'm expecting a fairly grand track. This is a really solid riff up against that slow-paced drum. I gotta say, just reading ahead, these lyrics are very densely poetic. Beautiful. Seems like there's some callings to the other tracks, maybe? Love that kind of western tone to that guitar there. Maybe this album is dealing with kind of like the darkness within us as well. And maybe that sickness is a metaphor. That guitar is having a somewhat rougher sound to it there. I believe that would be intentional. Atmosphere that's been going on for about 2 minutes now. Maybe longer. Nice slowly developing kind of world's building. Jesus, that pinging back and forth, because it goes right into this crushing sound. Again, these vocals, compared to the other metal band I listened to that did death metal, that doesn't quite match it, doesn't hold a candle. Don't get me wrong, I like the prog elements of this album, but the overall, you know, sense of it is not really coming together for me. Again, lots of themes of death and sickness. Seems like this is maybe a track about, you know, man's issues. Humanity's kind of downfall, I guess. Or like the evil within everyone. Blackwater Park left in eternal darkness. Maybe again a you know, commentary on humanity. And then we're gonna have some sort of soft outro here, it would seem, as we fade out and this album comes to a close. That does it for Blackwater Park by Opeth. 8 tracks, 1 hour and 7 minutes long, and I have to say I'm a little disappointed. I like prog metal from what I've heard, you know, Mastodon, for example, and I like prog rock in general, and the elements of prog on this are certainly strong, don't get me wrong. They are all fantastic players, they are all very technically proficient, but the overall, I guess, concept of the album and atmosphere of it doesn't quite land with me, and I think that's just a personal thing. I'm not trying to attack the album. I'm not trying to discredit it. I'm sure for those who seek this world that it builds and the atmosphere it creates, then this is a fantastic album. But for me, a lot of it, especially after the third track, kind of just felt a little disappointing. But those first three tracks, though, were incredibly strong, and I thought were just overwhelmingly the best tracks on here. The vocalist, I prefer him when he's singing in a much more restrained vocal style as well. I don't think his death metal, growls are for me personally. And then nothing against that. I'm a big fan of Symbolic by Death. I listened to earlier this month and I've gone back to it many, many times. I think this is a brilliant album. But in comparison, Blackwater Park's vocals with a similar kind of death growl doesn't quite do anything for me. But I don't know. I'll give it more listens. I'll give it more chances. Don't get me wrong. I always do. On a first listen, a little disappointed. But maybe it's because I expected more. But that's it for Metal March. That's it. No more metal albums will be covered on this channel. At least not some of the classics. At least not anytime soon. Because we are done Metal March. And we are moving on to April, where we will be doing a brand new genre where I will cover a minimum of 10 albums. That is the goal for every month. So if you're interested in that, go ahead and subscribe to see what that genre will be and the forthcoming genres every month. And any reactions that I do for new albums I will be doing here, in which case you can subscribe and follow along with those. But as always, my name is Randy Joe, and I'm signing off.